con Images e Imágenes, a special tribute to Tito Puente.
Tito has made it possible for young poor kids to have the opportunity to study music in his name. And for that reason alone, the man is in heaven in God's arms.
Tito was the staple, the concrete that held the Latin music business together.
He was a man, and whenever you ask him, how do you feel about yourself? You're very special, you're extraordinary. He says, are you crazy? I'm just a simple human being.
I think the name Puente means the bridge, you know, in English. And I think he was the bridge from the Latin community to the world with his music.
He was a showman. You know, he loved what he did, and he was always up. And that's what I'm going to always remember.
It's a sad thing, you know. I just hope he rests in peace. And I'd like to say to him, Tito, keep the music going. Because when I get there, I want to dance.
Fans from all over the world came to Tito Puente's funeral to pay their last respects to their fallen idol. Saludos a Miguel Pérez. While preparing this tribute to El Maestro Tito Puente, we came across many admirers of his music, but perhaps the most inspirational was that of his own son, Richie Puente. In 1993, he was mugged in his hometown in Miami, Florida. For 7 years, he remained partially paralyzed. To protect his skull, a steel plate was inserted in the right side of his head. He remembers the words of his father.
You will be able to play again, which, you know, I kept on thinking about it. I will be able, I just didn't know when. It took 7 years, but 7 years came, and he was right. I was able to play again, and I was ready to go, you know. You know, the only bad part is about it was when I started, he died, you know. That was the only bad part about it. But then, you know, the good part about it was that his name won't die, because I'm at a disability, and I want to continue it, and I'm going to continue his name and his music, because his music is great, greatest to me, you know, and to a lot of his fans, and I want to continue to get going.
In the late 1970s, Richie Puente had a hit called Foxy. He was also the opening act for superstar Michael Jackson. All of Tito's children have done well in the entertainment and television fields. It is a credit to Tito Puente, whose music became a tapestry of America's musical fabric. But who is this man crowned the king of the mambo, the king of the timbales, the king of Latin music? In 1992, our reporter, Mia Spillman, focused on the ambassador of Latin music, Tito Puente.
He was born Ernest Anthony Puente in New York City on April 20th, 1923. Today, he's one of the most recognizable figures in the Latin and jazz arena. Recently, he was given a Lifetime Achievement Award by the National Academy of Arts and Sciences and received a star on Hollywood's Walk of Fame.
The Walk of Fame, a Hollywood star. There, I got one there. And it took me 40 years to get that star, man. And you know who I'm next to, right next to me? Marilyn Monroe.
Tito Puente is a masterful musician who first introduced the vibraphone to Latin music. He was also the first Latin music band leader to be invited to the White House to perform for the President of the United States in 1979. With over 400 compositions to his credit, Tito Puente has won many music awards, including several Grammys.
The most prestigious award that you can receive from NARIS, because it gives you the recognition as a great musician or artist, vocalist or instrumentalist. And this gives our music to a lot of recognition worldwide. I won 4 Grammys and 8 nominations.
In 1942, Tito Puente was drafted into the Navy. By 1945, he had seen action in 9 battles during World War II and received a presidential commendation. Under the GI Bill, Tito Puente completed his formal education at the prestigious Juilliard School of Music.
During my youth, I went to Juilliard Conservatory of Music to study music, orchestration, arranging, counterpoint, piano, saxophone, vibes, drums, and I went to New York School of Music also. So I'm very happy to have been a graduate and put all that music and all that inspiration into my creative ideas as an arranger in the Latin field. And it shows now, because everybody needs that education. So I always tell the young people to go to school and study and graduate, because it's very important. We need you as arrangers and composers and instrumentalists.
Tito credits his parents, Ernest Sr. and his mother, Ercilia, for his successful career.
Yes, when I was a kid, naturally, I used to play on boxes and windowsills, cans, anything that had a rhythmic a sound to it, sure. And we used to jam out with a lot of the boys in the neighborhood, too. And with that, brings out the rhythm in you, shows that you have timing, you have clave, so there is talent there. So like the neighbors would tell my parents, why don't you put your son into studying music? He has some sort of talent. Because my mother wasn't aware of that, see.
As a young child, Tito became a trained dancer along with his sister, Ana. By the time he was a teenager, he had received lessons from the masters of Latin music and eventually played with the great legends like the renowned band leader, Noro Morales.
I played my first engagement when I was 13 years old with Noro Morales as a drummer. I recorded one of his tunes, Maria Cervantes, and Noro Morales was like, after Xavier Cugat, he was the greatest band leader that we had here in the United States.
In this 1940s musical film short featuring Noro Morales, Tito Puente is the drummer. After playing with outstanding bands such as the Machito Orchestra, Tito Puente in 1947 formed his own band called Tito Puente and the Piccadilly Boys. During the golden years of the mambo, the 50s and 60s, Puente was regarded by many as the king of the mambo, and the Palladium became the home of the best Latin music in the world.
The Palladium, famous ballroom known around the world as the home of the mambo. Everybody used to come to the Palladium, all kinds of different kind of people, nationalities, just to listen to the music and to dance.
Today, Tito Puente is not only the star among superstars, but he has two bands, a Latin big band orchestra and a smaller jazz band. During the Saravan Jazz Festival tribute at Newark Symphony Hall, Tito was asked to open the festivities. He did so with the renowned classic tune, Oye Como Va. Recorded by Carlos Santana, who again made it a hit on the popular charts. For Tito Puente, not only is this song a classic, but so are many of his albums. In 1991, Puente made history when he recorded his 100th album.
Well, when you get to 100, believe me, you've been playing a whole lot of timbales for a long time.
In this album, Tito Puente gathers some of the great legends of our music, along with a variety of musical numbers. His mission is to educate the public on the essence of Latin music.
The type of music we play on this album is supposed to be like Palladium Day music, like we used to play in the 50s and the 60s and the 70s, and now they call it salsa, see? But that word salsa is really a condiment for food. You eat salsa, you don't hear it, you hear music, see? So sometimes I get some of the non-speaking Latino audience, you know, an American always go, Tito, could you play me a salsa, you know? So I don't know what he means. So I thought, you mean you have a headache, you want an Alka-Seltzer? See, because actually the music that we were playing at the time is either the mambo, the cha-cha, the guaguancó, the guajira, the son montuno, guaracha, you know, all that kind of music. There was always a definite type of music, but now with the word salsa covers everything, so it becomes a... It's not the right word for that type of music. So now I'm trying to prove to the young generation that this is the music, the mambo, that we used to be playing, and I wanted to dance it that way. And I think they're coming around. We're getting more recognition on it.
Thanks to Tito Puente, mambo is making a big comeback.
For the last 2 years now, he's been giving me a grant through the scholarship, which has helped me establish the dance company, which I have now. I have a professional dance company of 10 dancers. And I also have an academy for children. So his support is genuine, as he loves to dance and he wants to see it continue to grow and develop here in New York.
The scholarship is already 12 years old. I've given out about 58 scholarships already. And the idea of the scholarship fund is to help out the young people that are going to college or to the conservatory of music, and they need a year more to get their diplomas or a bachelor's degree in music, see, or whatever, non-performing arts, really.
This program allows musically gifted children of poverty-stricken areas an opportunity to attend some of the best schools, including Juilliard. To see how the scholarship program works, we visited Boys Harbor in New York. This is how they feel about Tito Puente and his gift of education.
Well, Boys Harbor Inc. is a nonprofit service organization which has been serving East Harlem and Central Harlem for the past 50 years. And the Performing Arts Division started back in 1970. And we provide a wide range of music, dance, and theater classes for youth and adults of the tri-state area. And in these times of shrinking public money, the Tito Puente Scholarship Fund has helped us to continue serving, especially the youth of this neighborhood, with low-cost, efficient, professional music studies.
Hi, my name is Wilson Batista, and I'm one of the winners of the Tito Puente Scholarships. I've been studying piano for 4 years, and it's great. It's fun, and like the teachers are tough here, but you know, it's better.
Another accomplishment in Tito Puente's career is his participation in several films. In 1991, he completed a film featuring Armand Assante in the lead role. The title of the movie is The Mambo Kings Play Songs of Love, from the Pulitzer Prize-winning book by Oscar Hijuelos.
It's a story about two Cuban fellows that come up from Havana, they come up to New York, they call themselves the Mambo King, and they come up here to take over for Mio Machito or Tito Rodriguez at that time, but can never make it, you know. But we have a thing like the Palladium Ballroom, a real nice setting, and I think the people are going to enjoy it because the music is very good and the story is good. If the movie makes it, I think it'll help the music a lot, too.
Tito, thank you very much.
And your name will live on forever in history as one of our true heroes in the Latin community.
Amazingly, a few years ago, this Tito Puente record cost $1.99. Originally recorded in 1957, it features some of the great percussionists in the history of Latin music, Mongo Santa Maria, Willy Bobo, Julito Collazo. Today, it is a collector's item. Another collector's item is Masterpiece, Tito's last CD, recorded with his longtime friend, Eddie Palmieri. Here is Eddie and friends in a United States military tribute to World War II veteran Tito Puente.
Dedicated to Tito. On behalf of the United States Army in Fort Monmouth, New Jersey. Talk about Tito. There's about 38 Hispanic Americans that served in previous wars that all received the Medal of Honor.
Being a former soldier, we are deprived sometimes of stardom, professional entertainment to come out to our home, which we consider as the fort. And that is very, very special to have the honor as Tito Puente to perform here and then follow it up this year with Eddie Palmieri.
Tito Puente was the hardest workaholic, we could call, and the greatest bandstand warrior that we've ever had. We were always talking about doing a project together. Once we decided to do it, and I brought the compositions, the structures were how Tito Puente started many years ago. And that's why it became such an incredible CD. DCD, in my opinion, they'll have to deal with it for the next 100 years.
Tito Puente's music reflects the fervor and passion of Latino culture. And when you hear the pulsating rhythms, it's not exclusive to being a Latino, because you just want to get up and you really want to dance.
Since Tito Puente was one of my biggest inspiration, and we had the pleasure of opening for him last year.
A great tribute to him, and the fact that he's up above watching us now is a great thing.
I believe that he's already establishing the new Palladium on the moon.
Tito, 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 Tito.
Tito always joked about being the first Latino to play on the moon. After his death on May 31st, the year 2000, following heart surgery, a chain reaction of tributes engulfed the music industry. In New York, 110th Street in East Harlem, where Tito spent his childhood, was renamed Tito Puente Way. Ironically, it is parallel to 111th Street, the street named after Tito Puente's mentor, the godfather of Latin music, Frank Grillo, better known as Machito.
And I'm very proud for him about this dedication that they have a name in the street. Too bad it isn't from here to L.A. It'll be coast to coast, but I'm sure other states, other streets will follow. The man was a great man. He gave of himself, okay? He gave because he felt too much love for people.
Superstars Olga Tañón, Johnny Pacheco, and Celia Cruz joined forces to raise money for the Tito Puente Scholarship Fund.
These events are happening, and they're paying tribute to Tito Puente. But not only are you paying tribute to Tito, you're paying tribute to history. This man played 6 generations. He played all over the world. He opened the doors for a lot of our so-called big musicians today. Mark Anthony, who always says it. Ricky Martin, Gloria Estefan says if it wasn't for Tito, Carlos Santana. So I think it's important. I think all of these things are very important. And that this generation of today, they know the Mark Anthony's, they know the Ricky Martins, and they know the Glorias and the Jennifers. But I don't want them to forget who Tito Puente was.
Tito Puente's contributions to Latin and jazz have been acclaimed all over the world, but his dedication to kids will always be remembered.
I would like to declare that from here on forward, this auditorium will be known as the Tito Puente Memorial Auditorium, and that this portrait of Tito Puente will hang proudly at the entrance of the Roosevelt School. Yay, Tito!
Very happy that somebody came up with the idea of naming the auditorium Tito Puente, and I hope that in the future, many more auditoriums and schools will be named in his honor.
And now, the Tito Puente Orchestra.
Why personally did you choose to name the auditorium after Tito Puente?
Well, firstly, because I'm a great fan and admirer for Tito Puente, el maestro de música, for many, many years, even since I was a kid. And I've been dancing and listening to his songs for many times. I think he's an icon in our community. He's a Puerto Rican, just like I am, so I love him that much more. And I think that he's a great inspiration and a role model for all of our young children.
These children will always remember November 28, 2000 as Tito Puente Day at the Roosevelt School in New Brunswick. Meanwhile, New Jersey Salseros took claim of July 11, 2000 with a boat cruise in Tito's honor. Thank you.
Tito Puente is a personal loss because I knew him as a person. And last year we inducted him into the International Latin Music Hall of Fame. And ironically, this coming year we were going to give him the Lifetime Achievement Award. And unfortunately, this happened. I was in Puerto Rico when he first got the first slight heart attack. And it's a great loss. Tito Puente was an innovator. I don't think people realize how prolific he really was. In the first 20 years of his life, he did almost 70 LPs. It comes out to almost like one song every 14 days.
To me, he was the Babe Ruth of Latin music. He opened up the doors for us artists who came after.
Being here on cruise and getting to play Tito Puente's music is just an incredible honor because he's an amazing artist, an amazing, amazing artist. And I can't believe I'm actually going to be able to play a tribute to him.
He is truly going to be missed. The music he provided lifted the heart and the spirit and made you know that there was hope for a bright tomorrow just with his music.
We're so happy to see that so many people want to celebrate a man who gave us so much wonderful music.
It's a kind of music that it will burn your blood. Oh God, I cannot explain. And that's why he was so important for him to bring out our music all over the world, to tell the world that we had a music from heaven that is a language. It was a language. It was not only a music. It was a musical language.
We need to continue to support the legacy that he set out to promote the music, promote the Latin rhythms. And so I'm extremely happy to be here to support this event in his memory.
He's around us, and he wants us to succeed. He wants us to keep his music alive. And we're planning to do that. And for as long as all you people, wonderful people, all the fans of the Tito Puente, all you guys who were fans of Tito Puente and you guys want his music to keep alive, just keep supporting the Tito Puente Orchestra.
Steven Loza, in this book titled Tito Puente and the Making of Latin Music, compares Puente to the great jazz superstar Louis Armstrong. Their innovative contributions to the world of music will live on forever. Tito Puente wanted people to celebrate his achievements in life, and we did. Here at Images Imágenes, Tito Puente was a cherished friend and an inspirational leader for the children of our Emmy Award-winning NJN Hispanic Youth Showcase. We leave you with El Maestro, Tito Puente.
you feel it? Did you feel it?
As you all.